I've just demoulded one of the halves for the batch rocket burn chamber. It's made according to the Peter Berg model. This would be the front, wood would go in there. In this duct along the bottom there'd be a channel which takes air up and into the bottom of the heat riser for the secondary burn to happen. So you kind of get the idea here. I must say it's a lot more solid than the earlier ones I tried. This has got both high-alumina cement and fire clay as the binders. And the insulation is perlite and clay pebbles. I'll show you more than that another time. So obviously it will be assembled with another half sandwiched onto here. And then the chimney pieces would stack on top for the heat riser. So that's the casting. I'm quite pleased with it. I've been able to demould it within 6 hours of making the cast because the high alumina cement sets really quickly. I forgot to point out the narrowing between the burn chamber and the heat riser. So this narrowing here is what forces the air through where it can mix. The turbulence happens here. Fresh air coming through this one's preheated. Turbulence in here. And in the hot insulated chamber, the gases will ignite from the wood. So that's that. I'll show you quickly how I moulded this to pour it. So basically, I've just got here a piece of formica coated board, which I would clean up and grease if I was going to do a casting. And then I've got side box pieces, which are all made the same. They've got one, what will be a flush end, and one stop piece. So these go on like that, and each flush end meets the stop piece of the next one. So that one on there. That one on there. And then you'd square all that up with a square, using a you'd use one of these just to get everything square, and then you'd screw down onto the board with these tabs, and you'd join the side pieces together through these stop pieces there like that. So that enables you to get the correct size very easily, and it enables you to dismantle very easily. The plug I used for the casting, this one's had a couple of goes out of it now. If I just show you it there, it's made from solid foam insulation that was assembled with spray foam, so that's the kind of unimportant side of it, if you like. And this just fits into here like this. Now it's designed such that, let's put some light on the job. It's designed so that there's a 1.5 inch thickness for the wall all the way around. So all around there and along the bottom. That's a little extra piece that makes a channel to take the air channel. And then all I did was use some wooden blocks to keep one side from moving while I packed the other side with the refractory mix, and then just filled it up, leveled it off, took it to bits. So that's that really. So I mentioned the refractory mix I use. Among the cement was this stuff called cement fondu, which is the important thing is, it says on here somewhere, well actually it doesn't, but it's a high alumina cement, so it's good for 1200 degrees centigrade or so, much higher than ordinary Portland cement. I've made some in Portland cement and you get very heavy spalling in the heat of the fire and that eventually dies, so this is the stuff you need. Cement fondu, illuminate technology. And then the aggregates were regular perlite, which you're all familiar with. Large aggregate was this stuff, which are clay pebbles used by people to grow plants with. They've been fired to a very high temperature where they expand and form small pores, so they end up being extremely light. They should hold up to the temperatures of the burner without any trouble. The great advantage of this is strength, because when I used a high amount of perlite in the mix last time, it weakened it considerably, whereas these are effectively not contributing to the breaking up of the concrete matrix, because of course it just molds around them. So these were great, and that was the main large aggregate I used. These particular ones are called they're called Euro pebbles, and they're used by hydroponics people to grow plants in. So if you want to try those, that's what they look like. That's all for now. Please check back for the next episode, where I'll be showing you how I made the pieces for the chimney. If you have any questions, I'll try and answer them. And in the meantime, thank you for watching. Goodbye.